Hey everybody, what's going on? Welcome back here to another FIFA 22 squad tactics and formations video. And today we're going to be talking about the best tactics and formations to use for Real Madrid. That's right. So as you can see here in this video, I've decided to use a 4-4-2 flat formation with this Real Madrid team, with Karim Benzema and Vinicius Jr. being the two main strikers, and having Hazard and Rodrigo on the wing. And the reason why I've decided to use Vinicius Jr. as a striker is because not only does he have incredible pace, but he can be used as a really good attacking threat, meaning that, you know, he can draw defenders towards him, and you can use that to open up space to Benzema or maybe Rodrigo and Hazard. And with Vinicius Jr. running up and down the middle here, I think that you can really stretch your opponent's defense. And one of the reasons why I decided to use Rodrigo on the wing is mainly because he has 87 pace, so I think that's going to be very beneficial for this squad. As for defensive style, I use pressure on heavy touch, and for build-up play, I decided to go with fast build-up here, and for chance creation, I did forward runs. Now, as for Benzema, for player instructions, for support runs, I did drift wet. For attacking runs, you want to make him the target man and just leave interceptions on default. Now, as for Vinicius Jr. for support runs, you want to have it on drift wet. For attacking runs, again, behind, and for everything else, just leave it on default. As for Luka Modric for attacking support, you want to have him on stay back while attacking. For support on crosses, you have it on default, and for interceptions, I have him on aggressive. As for positioning freedom and defensive position, I have it also on default. As for Eden Hazard for defensive support, I have him on default. For chance creation, stay wide, and for support runs, I also made him the target man. As for Casemiro for attacking support, I have him on stay back while attacking. For support on crosses, I have him on stay of edge of box of crosses, and for interceptions, I have him on aggressive interceptions. As for positioning freedom, I have him on default, and for defensive position, I have him on cover center. As for Rodrigo for defensive support, I have him on comeback. For defense, for chance creation, cut inside, and for support runs, I've also made him the target man. And now for David Alaba and for Militao, I have them both on stay back while attacking and aggressive interceptions, and for defensive position, I have them both on default, stick to position. And as for Dani Carvajal for attacking runs, I have him enabled on stay back while attacking. For interceptions, normal, and for run type, I have overlap. And for left back, I'm using Mendy, and for attacking runs, I have him on joint attack, interceptions, aggressive, and for run type, inverted. Now, as for the gameplay footage here, right here is another example of why using this is really good. So right here, Luka Modric passes off the ball to Casemiro, who lays it off to Benzema here. So I'm scanning the field for an open man, and I managed to find Vinicius Jr. Once again, I'm waiting for a player to make an open run. I see Benzema making an open run. I go on goal, but that doesn't go in. And as for exhibit 2 here, so I'm starting off with the ball in my own half, and I'm trying to see where I can pass the ball to find some space here. So Carvajal lays off to Casemiro here, and he lays off to Luka Modric, back to Casemiro. Nice 1-2, and I'm doing a fast build-up. I managed to find Vinicius Jr. on the ball, then I see Benzema making a run, so I do a through ball right here, and then Benzema buries that inside the nets to make it 1-0 for Madrid. So this is another example of why using this formation and tactics is really good. And as for the final exhibit here, I'm going to show you why with this formation you can also have a nice little counterattack. So I dispossess Atletico Madrid inside my own half. I'm waiting to see if I can hit him on the counter. Mendy gets the ball, passes it off to Luka Modric. And we have Casemiro on the ball, scanning the field, do a nice little pass to Benzema. Then I see Vinicius Jr. making a run towards the box right here, but I don't think I have space to shoot, so I pass it off right here to Rodrigo, but the keeper saves his shot. So overall, I personally believe that this is the best formation and tactics to use for this Real Madrid squad, just because, you know, if you have Vinicius Jr. out in front right here, then he can be a nice little threat to opposing defenses, you know, and then he can draw defenders so that you can try and find other attacking options, like how I said in the beginning of this video. And as for playing players on the right here, you can also use Federico Valverde as an option for a right winger if you think that's going to be a better suitable attacking option compared to Rodrigo. So anyways, ladies and gents, that's going to be the end of this FIFA video here. So let me know if you find these tactics any useful here, and I love to hear responses in the comment section below. So anyways, ladies and gents, make sure you guys drop a like, drop a comment, subscribe to the channel, and let me know in the comment section below on what team I should do next.